Shalom. Okay, this is today's lesson, real quick, about a whistleblower here, all right? And it's about contact tracing and a warning, all right, of door-to-door forced vaccinations, Salak, and FEMA kidnapping campaigns, all right? So we don't know, when it all goes down pretty much, all right, but what we know is, all right, that they pretty much want to start now, all right. So we read this article, all right, and then we go into some precepts, and then I have a video here for you, all right. It's about 90 minutes, 19 minutes, all right. We will watch it, all right. I think it's important, but maybe I can, look for it in YouTube and make a little bit faster, because it, 19 minutes, all right. Let's watch that together, all right. Salak, okay, it's not here, all right. Right, but anyway, all right, let's read the article first. All right. Natural News. In a Natural News exclusive, a California-based whistleblower is stepping forward and sounding the alarm on door-to-door contact tracing campaigns, which are on the way right now, justified by the coronavirus pandemic government response. All right. These campaigns will be escalated to forced vaccinations and FEMA kidnappings, all right, of dissenters who refuse vaccines, we've learned, all right. So people who will refuse these vaccines, the elect, of course, all right, the 144,000, all right, and their family, all right, salvation to the household, all right. This video features a whistleblower we're referring to as Contact Traced, who is filmed in goggles, all right, and in hood in a hoodie, and a hoodie, hiding in a dark close to conceal their identity. This person believes they have already been added to a disenter red list, all right, in California, flagged for possible FEMA kidnapping and forced relocations to a FEMA camp where those who resist vaccines will be proceeded, processed and then exterminated. All right, that's what we pretty much said. All right, the whole time. All right, we said that. The elders. All right, the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. All right, double honors, by the way. All right, to them because they pretty much said that. All right. 30 years ago, all right, already. So, this is just true here, right? Because they already have their lists, all right. They have already their, who's maybe the elect, who not, all right, who will, most likely will take it, who not, whatever, man, all right. Most people, they join, they have, not they can trust the Lord that much, all right. Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. All right, that they, deny it, all right, in some cases. So even when they trust him now, all right, when it comes to the point that they have to make a decision, all right, they will be in failure, all right, at that day. All right, because it's the hour of temptation, all right. And we can read that not everybody is safe from this hour of temptation, you see. So actually, you can be some of them, all right, who actually have to face the hour of temptation, all right, and some elect will face it also, all right. So we don't know it, all right, but what we know is that a standard will be lifted up, all right, and Esau can just do what he wants to do, all right. That's just not what Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, all right, wants to have here, all right. All right, kidnapping and forced relocation to a FEMA camp, all right, where those who resist vaccines, all right, and the vaccines, all right, they will kill you, all right. So you may ask yourself, all right, what's the right decision, all right? if you take it, you will be dead by the poison in it, all right? Or by not taking it, you will be kidnapped into FEMA, and there you will be executed. So I have the right answer for you, all right? Because it's better to trust in Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, all right, to the God of the Bible, all right, than in Esau Edom, all right? And, you know, of course that's the right answer, all right? Of course it is. Okay, so this is serious here, all right? This person's voice has been dramatically altered to protect their identity, all right? So this person, you know, there are many people who spoke out against the so-called New World Order, all right? You know, this is not a conspiracy theory, all right? Because it's actually, you know, they say that directly to you, all right? They say that openly, all right, so to speak. So, you know, it's not a mystery, all right, or a secret, all right? So, you know, so how should it be a conspiracy theory then, all right? California government hiring people to go door to door, building red flag lists of, you know, dissenters, all right? So, you know, they're hiring people here, all right? And, you know, the military will do, you know, most part in this, all right? Right now, California is hiring people to go door to door, creating red flag lists of vaccine dissenters, flagging them to be forced vaccinated, medically kidnapped, or executed by California government authorities in the near future. All right, and you know, we want you, all right, and now it's here. And they will even execute people on the street, all right, because you know, killing will, of course, go on in the streets also, all right. Look at Germany, all right. I'm from Germany, by the way, all right. And we have here, like, you know, a policeman, all right, who said that there was never some, you know, some case like this week, all right, since he is in office, all right, like 40 years, all right. So, you know, it was crazy, pretty much, all right, to what he experienced before, all right. You know, compared to what he experienced, you see. So that's not coincidence, all right, because people pretty much, you know, they want to mess with the governors now, all right? Yesterday, we interviewed former FEMA administrator Celeste Solom, who confirmed that FEMA is gearing up to medically kidnap and forcefully place American citizens into FEMA camps where so-called anti-vaxxers will be exterminated. That's not a metaphor. They will be murdered by the state, you see. We've also confirmed from another source that FEMA's leadership has been completely overrun with communist operators who are planning on exploiting FEMA authority to flag and exterminate pro-America, pro-Trump dissent, you know, dissidents, all right, who tend to be vaccine skeptics as well, all right. And the truth about the so-called Black Lives Matter is also out right now, all right? We have also received documentation of the exact inventory of FEMA's killing machines, which have been distributed to FEMA centers across the nation and will be used to murder large numbers of dissenters who are flagged by FEMA, all right? Make no mistake, FEMA will be the vehicle of genocide in America, as the civil war ramps up and the murderous left attempts to round up their political enemies and exterminate them in death camps. All right, so basically, you know, FEMA is not a mystery at all right? It's also not a secret at all right? You can already see these FEMA camps, all right, being pretty much empty now, all right, because they will, of course, need people, all right, to do the work, all right, in these FEMA camps, all right? So you really think that they are there just to, you know, to be looked at? Of course not, man, all right? This is very real here, all right, and we told you that, all right? And, you know, the big "we told you so" will be also, all right, when most of you people are actually at the FEMA camps, all right, waiting for your beheading, all right? You see? Just imagine, alright, you being in, you know, you're standing there, alright, you know, you have two people before you, alright, you know, and then comes the next, we told you so, alright. That's true, man, alright, that's, the truth is stranger than fiction, alright. Remember that, alright. Alright. Of course it is true, man. Alright, of course it is. They will use vaccine compliance as one of the vehicles through which dissenters can be easily identified and later removed by force. Alright? In other words, being flagged as a vaccine resistor is now the equivalent of being placed on a government death list, you see, and that's marked here, alright, that's, you know, dark printed here, you see, and, you know, that's pretty much what it's about, alright, of being placed on a government's death list, alright, and door-to-door contact tracing campaigns are the mechanism by which big government is building these lists in preparation for the purge, all right? So, you know, the purge is for the so-called New World Agenda, all right? You know, they will, you know, look at you like an enemy, all right? Just by, you know, not taking this vaccine, all right? Watch this video and share with all your followers, all right? You know, and so on, alright, but let's watch this video, alright, so this is actually a good article here, alright, because this seems to be a good source, you know, of whistleblower here, alright, let's check that out, alright, I saw it, you know, I had to make a video on it, alright, because, you know, it's pretty much here, alright, in America, of course, alright, but this will come really to, you know, all over the place, all over the world, alright, of course.
Here today we have a secret contact tracer who is joining us anonymously to talk about the medical police state that is being rolled out in California. She has done extensive research on the contact tracing network and was in fact visited and perhaps intimidated by a COVID-19 contact tracer in Northern California, and she is warning the rest of us about what's about to happen to all of us as maybe a second wave is rolled out or a second bioweapon is rolled out. They're going to use that as a pretext to crack down on all human freedom using contact tracing, effectively medical martial law. So today we're joined by a person that we're calling Contact Traced. She has been visited by contact tracers in Northern California, and she's here to warn us about the danger that this poses to all of our civil liberties all across America. She joins us in shadow to protect her identity from the medical fascists in California who are probably going to arrest people who speak out against the medical police state that's coming. So thank you for joining us, Contact Traced. Where do you want to begin on this topic?
So according to that message here, all right, the elect would already be placed, you know, 10 times on these lists, all right? I think so, all right? Because actually, according to what he said here, all right, you know, because we are pretty much, you know, we're talking day to day from this stuff, all right? So I don't know, man, all right? But she actually was visited already. So this seems to be, alright, she actually was visited already, alright? So, keep listening, alright?
Thanks for having me on your show. I'm really concerned about contact tracing, and I have pretty good reason to believe they might start with California and maybe all the Western states to make anything of us. And the reason I got in touch with you about this issue is because 2 weeks ago, the contact tracer came to my house for the second time. He had come about 3 weeks earlier. Someone else was at my house and told him to go away, but the second time he came, I was here.
And well, really, let me ask you some basic questions. First of all, have you been diagnosed with COVID-19? Or is there any reason why they would think you had it?
I have not been tested for COVID-19 or diagnosed. In fact, I have been sick for at least a year.
Okay, so what do you think? They're just randomly hitting every house in California? How did they arrive at your front door, do you think?
I think the person who came to my home was actually what I'm calling a proto-contact tracer. There is a program called Community Emergency Response Team, known as CERT, C-E-R-T. And so these people are assigned to each block in the neighborhoods around Northern California, and I think it's a nationwide program as well. And they're gathering information on everybody on their block. And my contact tracer from CERT, actually it's not an official contact tracer, so let me be clear about that, it's somebody from CERT, the Community Emergency Response Team, came to my home and started asking invasive questions about whether there were elderly people at my home or if anybody needed food. And this was like at least two and a half months into the lockdown in California. So I thought it was really odd that 2.5 months in, they'd be asking if there were any elderly people who needed food at that point, because at that point, they'd probably be dead if they didn't have food. So the timing, I felt, was really odd.
Did he know your name when he came to your door? Or did he have any other information about you already?
He did not. He didn't know my name. He said he lived on my block, although I've never seen him before in my entire life.
So it sounds like the authorities in California are recruiting, you know, local block by block neighborhood, I don't know what you call them, COVID-19 snitches, you know, something out of the Stasi, SS, sort of, you know, community level enforcement, that where they're first assessing everybody to find out, you know, who lives where, and maybe they have a flag, you know, if you don't comply. Did you get any kind of pushback from him that way, where you felt like you were going to be marked because you weren't going along with what he was demanding?
Not overtly, but I did feel like he was noting that I was a dissident and didn't want him coming back, and I'm afraid that that information is going to be passed along to the contact tracers when they do come, and maybe I might be marked as a dissident, which is why I prefer to be interviewed in shadow today.
Do you fear that at some point this whole system will escalate to forced vaccinations on a door-to-door basis?
Absolutely. Yes, I don't think they really care about contact tracing every last one of us just to see who tests positive for COVID. I think this is a pilot, and they want to figure out how the contact tracing is going to work. They want to train their people in a real-life setting, because they all got trained online, and they want to get some initial information on people, so when the forced vaccination program comes along, that that'll go a lot more easily for them.
You know, it sounds like a cover story that they're pulling on the community to even call themselves contact tracers, because, you know, contact tracing works by asking a person who has been diagnosed, who were you in contact with? And that person creates a list of all their friends or family members or social interactions, and then they go visit those people, right? That's contact tracing. What they did to you is not contact tracing. It's more like a sweep, like a dragnet operation.
Yeah, it did feel like a dragnet operation. And one of my neighbors, my friend on a different block, she sent me information sheet that she got from her CERT person who came to her house the exact same day. And that information sheet was so invasive. It wanted the names, phone numbers, emails, and social media accounts of everyone in the household, their names, including children's names and children's phone numbers. And it wanted a local contact in case of an emergency and all their contact information, and an out-of-town contact with all their information as well. It was highly invasive.
Well, so I wish we would have covered this right up front. So what they're really asking for is everything you just mentioned, which sounds incredibly suspicious, that they want all your social media accounts and all the information about your children. That's extraordinary. They're building, obviously, a kind of like a, well, like an NSA type of database of interactions. I mean, they're building a database on their own citizens.
They are, exactly. And if you go to the CDC site and read about contact tracing, they even say they're going to ask for people's social media accounts as part of the contact information they're looking for. It's absolutely insane.
Is there any mechanism you're aware of where citizens can call a number and complain about this, or who's running this, and how are they transparent about what's going on? And was there any pre-announcement in your area that this was going to take place, or was this a total surprise?
That's a fantastic set of questions. There may have been a pre-announcement, maybe on Nextdoor, but I'm not on Nextdoor, so I didn't know about it, and there is no number to call as far as I know, unless we check the CERT site, the Community Emergency Response Team site. There might be a number to call about that.
So a strange person wearing a mask comes to your front door, peeks in your windows, asks you to hand over all your private information, leaves without giving you any identity, is wearing a vest and a laminated badge that anybody could print on their home printer. Is that about a good summary?
Yes, yeah, it is.
Okay, yeah, well, I would agree that you're right to be suspicious.
What really worries me about the contact tracers coming is that once someone tests positive, they're going to look back on those past 48 hours before someone tests positive, and they'll be able to look at your data from your app that they've downloaded onto your phone. If you have an iPhone, it's the update called 13.5. I don't know what it is on an Android, but they'll be able to look back over those 2 days after someone tests positive, contact all those people, and tell them that they have to go on an involuntary quarantine for 2 weeks. And then they can get off quarantine, be re-exposed, and get quarantined again. So people could conceivably be on back-to-back quarantines. And I'm very concerned that the unemployment rate might double because of that, from 40 million to 80 million. Because how can businesses stay in business if the employees are always on back-to-back quarantines? And then they might not come back to a job later because the small businesses are going to fold without the workers.
Well, at the same time as well, let's not forget that all the doctors and nurses that previously told us we had to not protest in public and wear masks and practice social distancing, they're now all saying that it's okay for Black Lives Matter protesters to protest and share all the air in public places. They don't need to wear masks. They don't need to practice social distancing. They're basically saying that everything they previously said was a complete fraud, since protesting is now more important because they support this particular social cause. That's more important than everything they previously said about a disease that they predicted would kill millions. And even further, this is my own commentary, but I'll ask for your opinion on this. Didn't they tell us that COVID-19 disproportionately kills Black people? And in some cities, I think 70% of the deaths were African Americans. And isn't it now those very same Black people that these mostly white doctors are telling to go out and protest and get infected? I mean,
That's another, important point, actually, all right. They say to you, all right, you can protest, all right, in peace, But at the same time, they don't want to have new cases of coronavirus, all right. So that's another sort of creating the problem, all right, because if you just would be honest, all right, or just like, clever, all right, but they want you to, to escalate there, to build these new cases, all right. They can't, of course, they can play with these numbers, all right. They can pretty much say, all right, there was a death, so we could say this is COVID-19, all right, even when there are, let's say, 10 COVID-19 deaths, all right, but they say, like, okay, 800 deaths, all right. Of course, they do that, actually, all right, but now they have a reason, all right, to blame it on you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, because actually, you gather it there on these places, all right, and you can't say you don't have it, all right, in some cases, because you maybe were around some of some people with COVID-19, so-called, all right, and COVID-19 is, of course, not deadly, all right, it's just like a flu, all right. But, they're playing with these numbers, all right, and they're playing basically with, with all you people, all right, gather themselves there, all right. Of course they play with you, all right. Real quick, all right, about 800 FEMA camp locations in North America, all right. And this is the same list what he talked about, all right. This is a, compilation, all right, of roughly 800 actual or suspected FEMA camp locations, all right. These locations here on the map, all right, these blue dots, are or could be operated by FEMA, Federal Emergency Management Agency, all right. And you know, this is again not a secret or a mystery. Should martial law need to be implemented in the United States, and all it would take is a presidential signature, all right, on a proclamation, all right, and the attorney, all right, general signature, Salak, okay, on a warrant to which a list of names is attached, you see? So, you know, they just have to put their, you know, put a signature on. Of course, they just have to do that, all right? That's basically what Trump the whole time did, all right? You know, with their ideas, all right, straight from the elites, all right? That, you know, the same ones who are already in these bunkers, all right? You know, this is just, you know, the old game from Esau Edom, all right? And they basically, you know, they have these undercover FEMA camps, all right? And they are in your, you know, what you have there. You have even Lidl or Aldi there in America, all right? I saw that in a brother's video, all right? We have that also in Germany, all right? You know, these day-to-day markets, all right, where you buy your, you know, your living stuff, all right? Your, you know, your food and your drink, all right? So, you know, some of these centrals, all right? These central markets, all right, or how should I say, you know, they already have, you know, in some cases, they already have, you know, some walls, all right, to basically make a prison out of it, all right. That's what they did already, all right. Look closely to these, you know, to these markets in some cases, all right, and you would actually see that, all right. They already have it, you know, at some point where you can actually think, all right, that it is a prison, all right, from the outside, all right. They just have to, you know, press a, you know, something, some, you know, some something there, all right, some button there, all right, and you know, there you go, all right. Something comes out of the walls, all right, and now it looks like a prison, you see. So that's, you know, that's what they will do, all right. So the preparation is already set, all right? They just have to put that signature, that martial law signature, you know, on there, you see? Of course, okay? So they're just waiting to basically come to your door, all right?
Why isn't this raising question marks in the minds of more people than just us?
I couldn't agree more. It's sanctimonious and duplicitous, and it's really a double standard. I mean, where were our First Amendment rights when we were first told we had a lockdown? And yeah, now that they support the Black Matter agenda, it's a totally different story. And what's really odd, too, is that one of the officials recently, and I can't recall who it was, said that they were going to prioritize African Americans as some of the first people to get the vaccine because they're so much more affected by it, and the death rate is higher in that community.
So what else? What else is on your mind that you think our audience needs to know? I mean, you're obviously very concerned. You maybe got a little freaked out by this person coming to your house, peeking through your windows, asking you all these questions. You believe that this is a precursor to maybe forced vaccinations that might, in fact, target Black people across America first. Those are all big things to be concerned about, but what else is on your mind that our readers and viewers need to know?
A few things. I'd say, firstly, the unemployment rate, I think, is going to skyrocket if people are on back-to-back quarantines, or even, you know, a quarantine a month is going to probably do that. And then, second of all, I think small businesses are going to go out of business. There is no carve-out for healthcare workers or anybody who's in contact with a lot of people who might have COVID. There's no carve-out for them. So are healthcare workers going to be on back-to-back quarantines as well? At least.
Okay, so really you can watch that, all right, on naturalnews.com. So, you know, it goes, you know, more in the details now, all right. I can even understand exactly what this guy is saying, all right. It's not really clear, all right. Maybe it's my speakers, all right, or my mobile phone. But whatever, man, you pretty much have to point right now, all right. This is Psalms 58 and 3, the wicked are estranged from the womb. They go astray as soon as they be born, speaking lies, all right? this is talking about the elites, all right, because they basically, you know, the only reason why they built these FEMA camps is because they, you know, they already predicted, all right, to pretty much deceive the people, all right, and kill them there, all right, to implement their so-called new world order, all right, because this is actually not an order, all right, this is chaos, all right, and a reason to kill all of you, all right, to pretty much to be the only people on earth, all right, and, you know, pretty much destroying themselves, all right, because if they would have the victory with the so-called new world order, all right, they would even destroy themselves, all right, you better might believe that, because, you know, it's written, all right, they would destroy themselves if Yahawashi, all right, would not return, all right, to pretty much destroy the whole, you know, so-called agenda, all right, and, you know, it's just what it is. So this is not a new world order, and really, all right, this is a new world chaos, all right, with, again, a reason to kill all of you, all right, and only for the super elite witch, you know, to be in harmony, as they say, all right, with nature, all right, when they are the ones actually, all right, who, you know, destroying nature at all right, only them, all right. So, you know, this is, you know, just a proof, man, all right, the FEMA camps are already there, all right. So it's not a secret, man. It's not a secret. It's not a mystery, all right. It's not some conspiracy theory, all right. And you're not safe because you are in Europe or you are in Asia, all right. Of course not, all right, because these elites don't just rule in America, Babylon the Great, all right. And, you know, the Americans, all right, the Babylonians, all right, with our Akium there, all right, you know, they have their own lot, all right, because the missiles will hit there, all right, and, you know, it will be different in these other continents and countries, all right, where, you know, for example, me, you know, I live in Germany, you see, in Bavaria, all right, to be exact, you see, so, you know, there will be differences, all right, but it's all the same elite, all right, it's all the same agenda, it's all the same family, all right, all the same bloodline, all right, all the same, you know, Esau Edom, the red people, all right, being here to deceive the people and pretty much, all right, starting with the vaccine, all right, killing you by peace, all right, killing you by peace, you see, so that's harsh, man, all right. Basically killing you by telling you, all right, we heal you, all right? All right? All right, let's get it real quick and then we'll close out, all right? All right? By peace, all right? And they shall, all right, the red horse in the Revelation, all right? The red horse, all right, by peace, the red horse will destroy many, all right? This is Daniel 8 and 25. And through his policy also, he shall cause craft to prosper in his hand, all right? So through his policy, man. And he shall magnify himself in his heart, and by peace shall destroy many, all right? By peace shall destroy many. Not by saying to you that this vaccine will actually kill you, all right, uploaded already a video about 50 million deaths, all right, coming with these vaccines, all right, according to Dr. You know, Dr. Chewy, you know, her name sounds a little bit like, you know, from, you know, you have Croatia, you know, and, you know, whatever. I don't know, man, but she's a doctor, all right, from, you know, somewhere, you know, in Europe or something, all right, and, all right, she's actually right with that, all right, because the Bible is saying, you know, is saying that he, all right, will destroy many by peace, all right, not by saying, again, all right, this will actually kill you, all right, or we will, you know, we will, kill you, all right, in a FEMA camp or something, all right? Of course they don't say that to you, all right? Why should they do, all right? Because everyone would wake up pretty much who, you know, who they are, and, you know, they have to lie to you, all right? He shall also stand up against the Prince of Princes, and that's, you know, that's talking about Yahawashi, all right? So-called Jesus Christ, all right? You know, the one who will come back with his chariots, all right? Because the so-called UFOs, all right, they are actually angels, all right? And the Prince of Princes is, you know, the prince of us, and we are actually princes, all right, here on Earth, but we pretty much look like, you know, pure people, all right? And, you know, the elites know who we are, but, you know, we look like poor people, all right? So nobody listens to poor people at all right? Or to people, you know, pretty much at the bottom, all right, talking about they are princes, all right? But, all right, this is actually fact, all right? Because the only prince above us, all right, you know, the princes, the Israelites, all right, is actually Yahawashi, all right? But you see that Esau Edom is basically making war with our prince, all right, the Prince of Princes, all right, Yahawashi himself, all right? But he shall be broken without hand, all right? All right, let's get that real quick, all right? Because these elites, all right, they know that they can't just walk up against princes, all right? You know, but they will do it because, again, they even, all right, will walk up against the Prince of Princes, all right? All right? So, you know, they're just waiting for the right moment, all right? But it's never a right moment, really, all right? So that's why they, you know, they pretty much, you know, they're a little bit afraid, all right? You know, I look for some video here, all right? You know, I saw princes on Earth, all right? That's what it's talking about. Okay, and you can read that, all right? Servants upon horses and princes walking upon the earth shall be no more, all right? This brother's video here, all right, is actually not the worst what I'm looking for, but, you know, it goes into that, all right? Servants upon horses and princes. Yes, okay, princes walking, you know, upon the earth, you know, that's actually, it's actually us, all right? Okay, Salak, so actually, you know, a daughter had it here, right? But you know what I mean, okay? Prince is walking upon Earth. Ah, okay, it's in Ecclesiastes, all right, 10 and 7. Okay, I have seen servants upon horses and princes working as servants, all right, upon the earth. All right, it's not what it's, you know, what's here. Not directly, okay, but this verse is going into that, all right. I have seen servants upon horses, all right, so that's talking about these super rich elites, all right, what, talking about they want to chip and vaccine you, all right, so they are on these horses right now, all right, thinking that they are actually something, all right, you know, with their cash pretty much only, all right, so that's what you know, they believe in their money, in their power, all right, when the only power what they have is actually from Yahweh Barashem Yahawashi, right, because he is the one who gave them that power, all right, but, you know, they don't admit that, all right, so that's why they have actually nothing, all right, that's why they have actually nothing. I have seen servants on horses, all right, that's talking about Esau Edom, the elites, all right, the Freemasons, you know, these super Freemasons, all right, who nobody knows, all right, you know, nobody saw them, all right, but they are the controllers, all right, and, you know, it goes all the way up to Satan, all right? And then you have Satan working for Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, according to Job, you know, 1 and 2. You can read it, all right? So they know what's coming from Satan directly, all right? But they don't know what's coming from where Satan gets his information from, all right? They know it, of course, it's from Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, all right? But they can't, you know, say what it looks like, all right? Because they only get it directly from Satan or from these demons, all right? So actually, you know, there is no power at all right? But Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, all right? And he gave the world into the hands of Satan, all right? And really, he's the one who provides that, all right, to bring judgment, righteous judgment, all right, upon the whole earth, all right? So that's why nobody is saved yet, all right? And that's why nobody, all right, especially not as Christians, all right, with the doctrine, is somehow, you know, out of nowhere, all right, righteous or, you know, some kind of saved, okay? I have seen servants upon horses, all right, and princes walking as servants upon the earth, all right? And the princes, again, are the 144,000, starting with them, all right? You can read it in Revelation, all right? Israelites, all right? You so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, all right? Or Indians, better said, all right? Okay? You are the Israelites according to the Bible, all right? And they know that. All right, and they especially want to vaccine you, all right, or especially want to put you in these FEMA camps or whatever camps they have, all right, it's not necessarily FEMA, all right, because it's really, you know, all over the earth, all right, not just America, so get ready, all right, because the next we told you so, all right, for some it maybe is the, you know, it maybe is the place, all right, where you pretty much will be beheaded or something, all right? All right, if we don't warn you, all right, your blood maybe is on our hands, all right, we don't want it, and, you know, we also love you pretty much, all right, so that's why we pretty much warning you at all right, and, you know, work out your own salvation, all right? So we are family, all right, and, you know, we all came from the same forefather, all right, so that's why there is some kind of cyber connection, all right, that's what I saw yesterday, all right, the porter uploaded the video, all right, check this out, all right, so we are really, you know, in a different connection than these heathens, all right, because if you go to the word cyber, you can see that also here, all right. It's a virtual, all right, you know, pretty much a different world, all right, you know, English, let's go into the English definition, you know, they can't do anything about that, all right, but they try to receive that on the left-hand side with this RFID microchip and, you know, with these chips, you know, relating to or characteristic of the culture of computers, information technology, and virtual reality, all right? So we are actually cyber people, all right? Where it is? Yeah, so we can communicate, all right, without having computers in our brain, whatever, all right? And they know that. All right, some would call it spirituality, all right, but actually it's a cyber network, all right, that's what I saw yesterday, it's pretty much a cyber network, all right, working especially if you actually from the forefather Jacob, you know, it's the truth, man, all right, it's funny, but, you know, it's also serious, all right, so they know that, and they want to pretty much destroy that, all right, by, putting that over the microchip in you, or, you know, vaccinate you, so that cyber connection, all right, and it's really not funny, okay, so that cyber connection is actually dead, you know, right after that point, all right, it's really dead after that, all right, so that's what they know, all right, and that's what they want to destroy, all right, by starting to vaccinate you Israelites out there, right? Because that's your connection to your higher power, and the only power what can bring you salvation, and you know to rescue you from this destruction that's coming, all right, and the killing, all right, especially from Esau, Edom, all right, for your Israelites, and even the own people, is is Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, all right, and this connection, this cyber network, all right, working to your spirit, all right, because it's always first a spiritual world, all right, even if you don't see it, all right, like the wind, for example, and you know they want to destroy that, you see. So it makes sense now, all right. If you think about it, all right, there's a cyber network. If you're coming from Jacob, all right, and you know, maybe you experienced it already, all right. If you're in this truth, all right. And with that, all right, Brock Dower Shai, all right. And you know, it's not a mystery, all right. It's not a secret, all right. FEMA camp is real, all right. These camps, they're all over the place, man, all right. And you know, they want to take your princes out, all right? Your Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, all right? But also your women, all right? Also your women and your children, all right? They're not stopping at your children. Of course not, man. They will kill your children, all right? Right before you, all right? Of course they do, okay? Shalom.